been a while since I've been on a bike. I'm not quite sure whether a 150-kilometre ride through the mountains of central Otago is the best place to get back on. But I'm assured that with a few bananas and a couple of muesli bars, everything's going to be okay.
All right, boys, let's roll.
The Otago Rail Trail winds its way from Clyde to Middlemarch in the central highlands of New Zealand's South Island. We're joining the trail at Otorohua, an historic mining town first linked by rail to the port city of Dunedin in 1900. The trains are gone now, and so are the tracks, leaving a perfect gravel surface for cyclists, walkers, and horse riders.
Discover, because this trail used to be a railway line and trains don't go up hills, when you get to a valley you go over it, and when you get to a hill you go through it. Very civilized.
Some tunnels stretch for hundreds of meters through the belly of a mountain, so bring a torch. I know the tracks are gone, but for some reason I can't shake the feeling that the light at the end of the tunnel may just be the headlight of an oncoming train. What is at the end of each tunnel is another dramatic vista framed by snow-capped mountains and rocky outcrops. The Otago Highlands can be impossibly steep and inaccessible, but the old railway line cuts an effortless swathe right through the landscape. Set a leisurely pace and you'll have plenty of time to admire the view and some impressive feats of engineering dating from the 1800s. We managed to put most of the day's mileage behind us by lunch. That left plenty of time for a cuppa and a chat with my trail team, Rod, Phil and Ash.
So Rod, I believe you've ridden the whole 150-kilometre trail.
Yes. Well, I was advised to do it over 4 days, and that wasn't because of my fitness, it was more because of my social desires.
Right.
I enjoy a cup of coffee and a glass of wine, and the 4 days makes it a leisurely journey.
Are there any bits that are quite hard, or...?
No, not really. If you break it up, most people take 4 days to do the 150k on the trail. Break it up, you're doing 30-35k days, 4 hours of riding, 3.5-4 hours of riding, so you can...
It's the odd time when it's a bit of an incline, it's about time you stop for a bit of a rest anyway.
The trail was opened in the year 2000 and has breathed new life into a region that hit hard times after the last train ran down these tracks in 1990.
Quaint old towns dotted all along the rail trail, and this one, Ophir, has the dubious honour of being both the hottest and coldest in the country. It is also the home to the longest operating post office in New Zealand. Now there's something to write home about.
There are 63 bridges along the trail, and this one over the Manuherikia River is the longest, at 111 metres. It's a great spot to clamber down the bank for a dip in the summer months, or if you're an angler, there's countless crossings over river stretches full of trout. The real pleasure of the rail trail is in the journey. It's not too taxing, and there's never any hurry to be anywhere. Although I can tell you, it's good to arrive at a refreshment house at the end of a day in the saddle.
Hiya.
G'day.
A massive amount of beer, please.
Four.
Thanks.
There's no shortage of places to stop for the night. They range from a basic room in a pub to a five-star B&B experience like the one you'll have here at Rocky Range. This French provincial-style manor sits on a hill overlooking the town of Alexandra and is surrounded by mountains. Each suite has a king-sized bed, an entertainment system, and every comfort a weary cyclist could wish for.
Now, I don't necessarily need this level of luxury, but I'll take it.
Unwind with complimentary drinks and hors d'oeuvres by the fire, or head outside into the acres of garden to contemplate what tomorrow on the trail may bring.
The central highlands of Otago are on New Zealand's South Island, about an hour's drive from Queenstown. Altitude Adventures have four-day rail trail trips starting at about $525 per person, including bed and breakfast accommodation, transfers from Queenstown and bike hire. Air New Zealand have flights to Queenstown starting at $302 from Sydney, Melbourne and Brisbane, and $562 from Perth.